When you talk about kings and queens, the British and French monarchies come to mind. And when you talk about France, the most powerful ruler in France was King Louis XIV, known as Louis the Great or the Sun King. His reign of 72 years and 110 days is the longest recorded of any monarch of a sovereign country in European history. France emerges during this period as a major world power and a cultural center to rival Rome, which had its own unique style. France emerges during this period as a major world power and a cultural center to rival Rome, which had its own unique style, the fountainhead of the Baroque style. And it was during this time that the thoughts of their king, King Louis, were widespread. He believed in spreading culturalism. So from architects, painters and sculptures, he had everything including high fashion. After the Civil War, known as the Fronde, forced a young Louis XIV to flee his palace in Paris, the monarch took a dislike to the capital city. Beginning in 1661, the king transformed the royal hunting lodge in Versailles, where he played as a boy, into a monument of royal opulence. In 1682, Louis XIV officially moved his court to the lavish palace at Versailles, 13 miles outside of Paris. Europe's grandest palace became a center of political power and a symbol of the king's dominance and wealth. In addition to the royal court, the 700-room palace housed the nobility that Louis XIV had brought into his sphere, as well as the thousands of staff needed for upkeep. Such was the power and influence of King Louis XIV that when Frenchman René Robert Cavalier, Sieur de la Salle, claimed the interior of North America, drained by the Mississippi River and its tributaries, for his country in 1682, the explorer named it Louisiana in honor of Louis XIV. When Louis came to the throne in 1643, the fashion capital of the world wasn't Paris, but Madrid. But King Louis XIV set out to change. That luxury was Louis's New Deal. The furniture, textile, clothing and jewelry industries he established not only provided jobs for his subjects, but made France the world's leader in taste and technology. Nothing that could be made in France was allowed to be imported. Louis once ordered his own son to burn his coat because it was made of foreign cloth. It was an unbeatable economic stimulus plan. As he waged a never-ending series of expensive wars across Europe, the French luxury goods industry replenished his war chest and enhanced the king's reputation at home and abroad. But after his reign, the French monarchy was never able to be the same again. And all the wars eventually took their toll on the French people. And this led them to fight back. And in 1789, the French Revolution took place. But this wasn't any different than the other monarchies that were run. Almost a century and a half later, In Russia, the Russian Revolution was also led by the people and eventually led to the monarchy being overthrown.